Hi, it's Tink here, and today I'm gonna actually get around to doing my wardrobe tour. So let's start. So we'll start with the first one that I'm wearing, and this is Chocolate Quartet or Quartet Chocolate, I've seen it written different ways, by Angelic Pretty. And I have the JSK in this cut, and I think it's like the ivory colourway with the matching head bow, which I've added this bit to. I'm just going to go through all my main pieces that I have at the moment. So I've been collecting Lolita dresses for the last 2 years, so let's have a look at how my collection has grown. So one of the first items that I've purchased was actually a bodyline two-piece set, which has this little sailor jacket and skirt, and I wore this, well, the skirt at least, all the time when I first started in Lolita, but I don't wear the top part of it very often. I bought this set as it came with a beret as well, and I thought it was good to have a few pieces just to make an outfit and put it together. My first main brand piece I got from Closet Child, and it is Dress Up Princess by Angelic Pretty, and it's got such a big skirt. I got this for my first big tea party, and this is Queen Bunny by Angelic, and it is a one piece and extremely comfortable. My next dress is Harlequinade by Angelic Pretty, and I have to say it's one of my favourite prints. It's made with a very soft, silky fabric, and has an underskirt with lace, and I really, really love this cut. It also comes with a little belt that goes around, and it has lovely, delicate lace on the shoulders and a sheared back panel. This is one of my top two most worn JSKs. It's currently missing two of the star buttons, and I'm trying to get replacement ones that look exactly the same. And this is Zoo Tea Party by Hallberry, and it was, I think it was the first JSK that I ordered, and I did it on pre-order. And the print is absolutely beautiful. This is another JSK that is extremely comfortable, and the lace is very, very soft. It has little star buttons as detail, and the back is fully shared, which is why it makes it so, so comfortable, and it also comes with waist height. This is probably one of my top two favourite dresses that I own, and this is Angelic Pretty's Magic Princess. At the moment, it's currently missing the stars at the top because I just need to repair a couple of the little links, as they catch very, very easily on different things. The front bow is a gorgeous shape with lovely little star charms, and it has a very glittery print. This also has, this is the Napoleon cut, so it has, I think they're called like apples, because apple means shoulder in French, and they're kind of like little details that sit on your shoulder. This one is fully back sheared as well, which makes it super comfortable. And the waist ties, which I haven't put in my drawer, have each of the castles on it. It's one of my absolute favourite JSK. This dress is Strawberry Whip, and I bought it on an impulse before realising that the bodice is unlikely to fit because of the way that it's shaped, even if I was a slimmer size. So I'm looking for this one in, I think it's called the mini sleeve OP cut, where it's much more stretchy. It does have a sheared small back panel segment, and I absolutely adore the print on this one with lots of strawberries, cakes, and it's one of my favourite prints, but I need to get it in a different cut. So if you are selling the other cut of it, please let me know. I am very happy to trade. It also has some beautiful little flowers And I just love the combination of the colours on this dress and the lovely little pink bows at the bottom. Perfect for a picnic. This very simple dress is by Metamorphose, and my friend had it in the white colourway and I found it very quickly after I saw her wear it in the pink colourway. And the reason I love it so much is it is so very versatile. It is so lightweight and summery and soft and stretchy, and you could just wear this sort of all the time because it's just so unbelievably comfortable. It also has a bow that you could put on the front or put in your hair, and this JSK, even though it looks a little bit limp on the hanger, is seriously one of my most comfiest dresses that I own, and very worthwhile getting for a more casual Lolita look. This beautiful summery dress is by Souffle Song, and I believe it's called Don't Eat Bunny, because on the print it says Don't Eat Bunny, very small. It's a very, very pale saxe, very, very pale bluey green, and it is very, very lightweight, very, very soft, very, very comfortable. It has a small sheared panel in the back. The bunny rabbits are wonderfully placed. I think it came with like 3 detachable sort of creamy bows, which you could put anywhere. It is very, very good for the summer. It has lovely, very soft lace at the bottom. And on the print, there's like even little donuts and strawberries and cakes and little sort of pinky cameos in the print. It is a lovely sort of understated dress that you could wear even if you weren't wearing a full over the top Lolita cordoner. This dress, I believe, is called Picnic Rabbit, and it is by Infanta. One of my friends was wearing it in, I think it was the brown, could be wrong, brown colourway, and I absolutely loved it. The thing I love most about this dress is the texture of the material. It's almost like a like tapestry is the best way I can describe it, with how it's sort of textured and embossed. It's got a shiny feel to it. I have actually let this dress out at the back, although you can't really tell. I have undone some of the pleats so that it is a little bit more comfortable. And it's got a back panel there, with straps that go across. A lot of my dresses have taken the straps off, but a lot of them do have them laced across the top. And the beautiful bunny print, this is really, really good for picnics, with little mushrooms on, happy bunnies picking their berries, and strawberries and cherries all over this dress. So you can coordinate it with your favorite fruits. This is a very, very cheap dress from Bodyline. I can't remember what it's called, this like sweets, tarts, the tart dress. I believe Infanta also, I think it was Infanta, also had this print in a dress, and you can tell the difference between the Bodyline and the Infanta one because that one has white lace rather than this sort of dusky pink. I've always had trouble coordinating this one, but I absolutely love how the print stands out with the big tarts and the big brown and beige bows, and this one is always my sort of challenge on how am I going to coordinate it next. But it is very comfy. It has a small back panel of shearing there, and it has waist ties which are non-detachable. I think this is the only dress I've got where they're non-detachable, zip down the side, and very comfy and great if you just want to kind of like not worry about what you're wearing because it's just such a cheap dress. This is one of my all-time favourites, and you've seen it before. I bought it in Japan, and this is Marine Kingdom. It has the most amazing inbuilt petticoat, which is really, really thick and heavy and just gives a lot of poof to it before you even put any other hoops or petticoats underneath. It has a non-detachable bow at the front. I love this cut. I can't remember what it's called, but it is really lovely for showing off sort of white lacy shirts. And it has, the great thing about this is the whole of the back is sheared, which makes it unbelievably comfortable. It has lace around it with bows on. The print is absolutely stunning. The waist ties have little bows at the bottom and lace. And what just makes this the most amazing dress is literally just the print is gorgeous. It has got mermaids and castles and seashells and gems and jewels, and it's just got so much detail in the bottom of the print there, and it's got so much fabric to it. I love it. It also has a detachable bow which you could wear possibly either as a head bow or just to add to this one to give it even more impressiveness, even though you don't really need it with this one. I normally get the name of this one wrong. It is either called Ridiculous Circus or Ridiculous Rabbit Circus, something like that, and it's by Baroque, and it is a lovely classic Lolita dress. It has a panel showing at the back, making it very comfortable. It just fits right, and it also has a detachable bow, which I often use on headwear because I don't have anything really that works as a headpiece for this, so I normally steal the bow off it. And I love the black and white sort of tile effect. And you have, the reason I love it, and you can probably tell, is it has bunny rabbits on it, circus bunnies, and unicorns, yes, for the unicorns. This one also has, if you are a fan of hamsters, gerbils, little mices, it has little hamsters with moustaches. So yeah, this dress is really lovely if I want to wear something kind of a bit more understated. But it's got really kind of intense shoulder ruffles, and it's quite difficult to work out what to wear under them because of how ruffly they are. But I really love it, and I do wear it out quite a lot because it's not as over the top in your face kind of dress. And you can coordinate it with so many different colours in the print, even like sort of dark red would be a really lovely way to coordinate it. But it's got so much detail in it, and it's kind of a more clashing bright colour than some of my other dresses. I don't wear a lot of yellow, and this has got quite a lot of goldy yellow in, so that's a bit different for me. But I do wear it quite a lot, so. We are coming towards the end of my dresses so far. This one is, I'll put the name, by Infanta, and I got this because I wanted a dress that screamed Halloween at you when you wore it. You've probably seen it before in some of my videos, but this one has got skulls and books and is quite witchy. And I love the colour contrast of the red with the kind of cream and spider webs, and they're cute skulls. I have a thing about, I don't really like realistic skulls, but cute skulls I'm okay with. And there's like candles, and there's sort of like very sort of classic items on there. I think there's a magic wand on there. And there's even a teacup. And a castle, a haunted castle, and bats and things. So this is really nice when I kind of want to wear something for Halloween that's, you know, a bit more appropriate, I guess. Like, it is, I really like this one from Infanta. It's really easy to wear. I've worn it quite a lot. And it does have waist ties too. With actually, it has quite long gold tassels on the ends of the waist ties. Which are quite effective. There's a theme with my purchasing of Infanta dresses. This one is by Infanta. I'll insert the name here. And this one is sort of my like go-to Christmas dress, or like very, very relaxed Lolita wear. I love the sailor collar on it, the very, very soft lace on the arms. And the fabric is very soft. It's very silky and very comfortable and lightweight, but you could also layer it up for Christmas. It does have crossovers at the back, and the collar does have this lovely sort of velvetiness. It did suffer quite badly in the wash from the collar going very pink, which you can't really get away with very easily because you're putting the red and the white in the washing machine at the same time. So if anyone's got a tip on how to do that, maybe a colour catching sheet in the wash. But this does wash well because the fabric it's made of, and I would just chuck it in without worrying about, you know, what might happen to it. So I do love this dress. Absolutely, it's really comfortable. and this is kind of a main piece because I don't have any other skirts apart from the pink one in the bodyline set. And this one is from Metamorphose. I'll leave the name for you. I think it's something to do with Enchanted Princess possibly. And the great thing with Metamorphose is a lot of their skirts are very, very stretchy. Angelic pretty skirts are absolute no-go for me. There's no way I'll ever fit into one, sadly. But this one is just so elegant and very classical with like that hint of sweet that I love. It has got roses and, is that a perfume bottle? Perfume bottles and like cameos, and there's a cake, and it says on it Metamorphose ton de fille, and it's got just really, really ornate purple, lilac-y, lavender-y, filigree on it, and there's some crowns, and it's very princessy and just absolutely gorgeously comfortable and very nice to wear with sort of normie outfits as well. My last main piece is one of my dream dresses, which some of my others are dream dresses too, but this one is a particular favourite. And this is Salon de Thé Rose, which is currently on my body form, which I quite like to stick in the corner, lay out coordinates on it, and just admire the dresses. It's stunning. I think I'm like maybe a couple of inches away from fitting into it, so I'm just keeping my fingers crossed. If not, I am maybe considering getting it altered because it is one of my favourite prints of all time. And the reason I love it is because of just the delicate patterning, the beautiful, beautiful teacups and roses and leaves and ribbons. I love roses, and I think it's like sort of delicate roses, and how the pattern flows for me, I've said this before, is very important. There's a pocket in there. Some of my other dresses do have pockets too. I'm not sure if it's got one on that side as well, I can't remember. It's that side's got the zip, so normally you don't have a pocket on the side that there is the zip. And it's just gorgeous. It's got this lovely ribboning down the front, and on the back it has also got ribboning. It's quite good, it's got quite a big sheared back panel, but with a lot of Lolita dresses the problem is once you get to the bottom of the sheared panel, this bit where it's pulled in, there's not a lot of give, so that can affect wearability. It's got little pearl buttons where you can adjust the straps, and it does have waist ties that come with it as well that attach on the buttons on the side. And it's just an absolutely stunning print to me. I really appreciate this print and the effort that's gone into making it. I love the frilliness that it goes all the way around, and I really like this swooping neckline, which I think is absolutely gorgeous. It also came with, and this is the only dress that I have, a bonnet with. It has the matching bonnet, if you can imagine. And it also has a couple of other extra bows. It's got a bow that can go here, I'm just looking on my accessory board, and it's got another small bow with some roses on, which you kind of fit in into the bonnet. So this is when I can eventually wear this, it will hopefully come together really well, and I'm really excited about it. These pieces are gorgeous. It's kind of like a lace fabric, and it has it's just delicate, it's so delicate. And the bonnet has these beautiful bows on here, and it has these gorgeous little bows coming around there as well. So there we are, that is my 2018 Lolita wardrobe. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please like, comment and subscribe to encourage me to do more, and please check out my Patreon, because this channel is currently demonetized, and every little helps support my channel and help me to get more content out there. Thank you to my current patrons. Without you, I wouldn't still be doing this. You guys are awesome. Take care, and I will come back soon with more videos, possibly on my shoe collection, my accessory collection, my jewelry collection. What would you like next? Let me know. Come back for more cute kawaii loveliness. See you soon. Bye. Quite intense.